During his service, he will be telling you more of himself, where he's been, what he's done. Just two things. He recently served in Church of the Holy Cross in Hilo as interim, and more recently in Eva Community Church. So, after this service, please introduce yourself, get to know him. We'll be having some refreshments in the gym right after this service. Thank you.
Good morning again. And our announcements this morning is quite a bit. After our service this morning, we would like for all of you to join us for a light refreshment treat. And this is to welcome our pastor. And I would like to thank all of you that have been praying for me and my family, for Manny and his family, my mom, passed away in Las Vegas, but she's back home now. And her services are next Friday. Manny's brother lived here in Cleveland, and his services are next Friday. They're overlapping each other, so he and I will have a full day. Anyway, thank you all for all your prayers. Please continue to pray for us. Palm leaves. We need fresh green palm leaves for Palm Sunday. Please drop them off at the church on Saturday, April 13th. There will be buckets out in the lawn with water where you can eat it. Special mission offering. Thank you for the overwhelming and generous support from everyone who donated to One Great Hour of Sharing. Last Sunday, we collected $1,145, praise God. That will help to support people affected by disaster. You may also donate today if you like. Also next week, April 14th, Merle and Claudia Wines, they will be joining us at each of the services to share with us and give us an update of their work in Africa. Also, not in your bulletin, but there will be a pastoral search committee meeting next Sunday, which is April 14th at 11:30 a.m. in Quok Chapel. April 21st, Easter Sunday, you're all invited to breakfast, as you know, but we need you to sign up in the Evalonai, and it will be from 8:30 in the morning to 9:30. Women of Worship, the WOW Bible Study, April 6th to May 11th, the Parables of Jesus by Matt Williams. Please join this class for 6 consecutive weeks, Saturdays in the morning at 8 o'clock from 8 to 9:30 in room 307. If you'd like more information, please contact Shelly Harmon. The Women's Board of Missions meeting and lunch April 27th. With God, all things are possible. Ever so true. Their annual meeting and fellowship to be held Saturday, April 27th, from 10 a.m. to 1:30 at the Central Union Church. Tickets may be purchased $35 by contacting Gloria Young. Deadline to purchase the tickets is April 10th. Please submit announcements for the church bulletins by Wednesdays. They will need to be approved. All announcements are shared for translation and those doing the Chinese bulletins. Church bulletins for both congregations will be printed on Fridays. I think this is the part three of the estate planning. The workshop session, yes, three. April 13th, end of life decisions, health directives, and hospice. Please RSVP to our office. And I thank God and praise God for the life of my mom and Manny's brother. Thank you. Before I continue, are there any visitors this morning? Any visitors? visiting us today. I see Ted and Phyllis, and it's always so wonderful to see you both whenever you can make it. God bless you. Please stand for our call to worship. Come, beloved, for the great giver has restored your fortunes. Let us tell of abundance, as we shall be fulfilled. Come, brothers, for the Creator has brought up rivers in the midst.
Give us a clear grace, as we repent all of Jesus.
Come, pilgrims, for the righteous one has set a path through the sea.
Let us rejoice, as we make our children.
Come, people of God, for the Holy One has done great things for us.
Let us worship God.
Lindsay, you may be seated. Thank you. Lindsay will now lead us in our liturgy.
This is the liturgy for the blessing of our interim pastor. And let's reflect and really be mindful of the words, because this new beginning is a two-way street. Pastor will assist us, we will assist pastor, with God being the traffic director. The liturgy says, dear Christian friends, baptized in the priesthood of Christ, we are all called by the Holy Spirit to offer ourselves to the God of all creation in thanksgiving for what God has done and continues to do for us. Today, we give thanks to God for the ministry that God has provided to the people of the First Chinese Church of Christ in Huami, and for the faithful service of its members, former and former pastors, most recently Pastor Kakami. And now we begin a new part of this journey with our interim pastor, Chula Yo. A part of this, we ask God for guidance for our ministry as we join together in prayer. Let's respond in unison. Gracious Lord God, we pray for us, sustain us for many years, and give us.
May God bless us and lead us.
Please join us for our opening hymn. Please stand when you would like to. Thank you.
Thank you. Because like some are already asking.
Servant, and remember me, and not forget thy name, servant. but wilt give to thy maid servant a son, then I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life, and no razor shall touch his head. As she continued praying before the Lord, Eli observed her mouth. Hannah was speaking in her heart. Only her lips were moving, her voice was not heard. Therefore Eli took her to be a drunken woman. And Eli said to her, how long will you be drunken? Put away your wine from me. But Hannah answered, no, my lord, I am a woman sorely troubled. I have drunk neither wine nor strong drink, but I have been pouring out my soul before the Lord. Do not regard your maiden servant as a base woman, for all along I have been speaking out of my great anxiety and vexation. Then Eli answered, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant your petition, which you have made to me. And she said, let your maiden servant find favor in your eyes. Then the woman went her way and ate, and her countenance was no longer sad. They rose early in the morning and worshiped before the Lord. Then they went back to their house at Ramah. And Elkanah knew Hannah, his wife, and the Lord remembered her. And in due time, Hannah conceived and bore a son, and she called his name Samuel. For she said, I have asked you of the Lord. And the man Elkanah and his house went up to offer the Lord the yearly sacrifice and to pay his vow. But Hannah did not go up, for she said to her husband, as soon as the child is weaned, I will bring him, that he may appear in the presence of the Lord and abide there forever. Elkanah, her husband, said to her, do what seems best to you. Wait until you have weaned him. Only may the Lord establish his word. So the woman remained and nursed her son until she weaned him. And when she had weaned him, she took him up with her, along with a three-year-old fool, an ephah of flour and a skin of wine, and she brought him to the house of the Lord at Shiloh. And the child was young. Then they slew the bull, and they brought the child to Enoch. And she said, oh, my Lord, as you live, my presence is, I'm sorry. Oh, my Lord, I am a woman who was standing here in your presence, praying to the Lord. For this child I pray, and the Lord has granted me my petition, which I made to him. Therefore, I have lent him to the Lord as long as he lives. He is lent to the Lord, and they worship the Lord there. Now the boy, Samuel, continued to grow both in stature and in favor, and the Lord with men. And there came a man of God to Eli and said to him, thus the Lord has said, I revealed myself to the house of your father when they were in Egypt, subject to the house of Pharaoh. And I chose him out of all the tribes of Israel to be my priest, to go up to my altar, to burn incense, to wear an ephod before me. And I gave him to the house of your father all my offerings by fire from the people of Israel. Why then look with greedy eye at my sacrifices and my offerings, which I command and honor your sons above me by fattening yourselves upon the choicest parts of every offering of my people, Israel? Therefore the Lord, the God of Israel, declares, I promise that your house, the house of your father, should go in and out before me forever. But now the Lord declares, far be it from me, for those who honor me, I will honor, and those who despise me, I shall be slightly esteemed. This is Matthew. And Jesus came and said to them, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always to the close of the age. This is the end of our scripture reading. And now we will have our wonderful choir as they sing, "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross."
Thank you. 50 volts, and the stars of my prism can see much better. I have noticed what was really used to hide all those ugly stars. And I swore my head, not only because I'm losing my nose, but I'm also beginning to lose my hair. Be kind to my short aunties, there are many. Be patient to my little pigeons. At least know I am vulnerable. And please, don't look at me that way when I'm having a senior moment. And look at that in the other day by asking you to please be good to me. You may say to me, Pastor, you're going to preach 3 sermons this morning. There are 3 titles of 3 sermons: Lent to the Lord, Honor the Lord, and Unto the Uttermost Parts of the Earth. Is this why you are asking us to be good to you? I'll share with you what I've shared with the search committee. And evangelist said to the pastor, Brother, you know I'm an evangelist. I preach long sermons, 45 minutes at least. So how long do I have today? Said the pastor to the evangelist, Brother, you can preach as long as you like, but come 11:30, my members will stand up and go for their refreshments. Lucky you, they don't say, after your preaching, we appreciate our happy hour. Lucky you, they don't say, after your preaching, we not only deserve our happy hour, we need our happy hour. Lucky you, they don't say, hey, Reverend, we love you very much. But that was before you started preaching. And so, Lent unto you. And I know all of us have done that. There was a time you said to God, as long as I live, my life is Lent unto you. To be a preacher, to be a usher, to be in the media that field. To be a lay reader, to be organs, and Auntie Esther is an organ. Organ comes alive with the sound of music. To be a choir director, to be in a praise team, to be a lay reader, to serve, not to chair in this committee or that committee, and then be accepted for all. And so, we're just glad. It is good we stay again as long as we live. We are led unto God. And for me, that happened one evening, one soon evening, I had to go to the evening. When the evangelist had rallied, in the altar call. For 4 days in a row, many people went up to receive Christ as their Lord and Savior. overwhelmed by the English accent, even a small London, yet a West End accent. Oh, it's lovely to be here, old chap. And it's what is London, the cop needs. If you ask them to wind the table, they are very polite. And they say, oh, I shall be delighted. I shall be delighted. As you go further up northeast to Newcastle or Darwin, then you will hear, hello, 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 and hello. That's the version of hello. And you go further up north, Scotland, the accent comes smaller. And then you hear, oh, nah, it's a breath, nah, nah. forgiveness. He said, then eat. This is my body, broken for you. This is you in remembrance of you. And so we get a very clear instruction, command from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, do this in remembrance of you. After the same manner also, he took a cup and said, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. Pour out for many. Unto remission of sins. Drink ye all of this. And following his example and command, we do this. I set apart all these elements from all common uses to this holy use and mystery. The gifts of God for the people of God. Come, the Lord's table is ready.
Thank you. Please stand for our doxology. Thank you. I'm so glad we have a forgiving God.